He's my most memorable artist. You know, I've produced a lot of great ones, but he's my most memorable.
A film covering the mysterious disappearance of a folk singer, the lasting impression he made on a generation, and the two South African fans that set out to discover what became of him. Downstream is proud to present Malik Benjaloo's 2012 documentary, Searching for Sugar Man. In the 1970s, a Detroit-based folk rocker, simply known as Rodriguez, would release two highly praised yet commercially dead albums. As he slowly drifted into obscurity years later, his music would go on to become wildly influential and insanely popular in an unlikely place, Cape Town, South Africa. Where Rodriguez's music was more than just a summertime vibe, but the soundtrack of a revolution, as thousands of South Africans protested racism and the anti-apartheid movements. The main question is, how can somebody so talented, so enlightened, so revered, just disappear?
Just coincidence, at the time I was looking for subject matter to write an article. I remember having like 5 points on the piece of paper, and number four or something was find out how Rodriguez died. You know, I thought it would make a good story.
There were rumors that his depression, due to the commercial failures of both of his albums, led him to commit suicide live on stage. This was an urban legend believed to be true by most Afrikaans culture because of the heavy censorship and restriction of information by the government.
And finally, I got to the one question I wanted to know the answer of was, how did Rodriguez die? Did he blow himself up on stage, or what is this dramatic story? Let's open up the lid on this right away and find out what happened.
Simply wanting answers, our subjects scour over lyrics looking for clues of where Rodriguez might live. They call record companies, even build an internet forum in the relentless pursuit to find any information they can about a musical hero.
Sugar man, won't you hurry? 'Cause I'm tired of these scenes. For a blue coin, won't you bring back all those colors to my dreams.
In respect to the wonderful story, I won't spoil or tell anything, but the information they gather paints the portrait of a man who never needed money or international stardom to live a good life. With absolutely fantastic music, a wonderful art direction that seamlessly incorporates animation with archival footage, and a gripping, fascinating subject, Searching for Sugar Man comes with our highest recommendation. It leaves Netflix Saturday, August 1st. You won't want to miss this. Who never needed money or international stardom to live a good life. You got a good life.